Namaste friends, welcome. Holly Yogi here. So glad you found my channel. Today we're going to talk about a little known, little talked about muscle in the yoga world and even beyond. That's a part of your deep core. Before we get started, be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and head over to hollyyogi.me for a lot more free information, yoga education, and articles. So, what muscle are we talking about here? This is one of your deepest core muscles called the multifidi. It runs from the base of the spine to the base of the skull. And it's a series of muscles. So a series of little kind of quiet yet powerful muscles. They connect the joints between each vertebra. So they run all the way up. And what they're here to do is protect the spine, support the spine, especially the joints. Unfortunately, they've been studying this muscle for about the last 30 years over MRI scans and trying to see if there's a correlation between atrophy of the multifidi and back pain. And there most certainly is. And they can actually see this on an MRI. They can see what a healthy muscle tissue looks like, one that's online, one that has tone. And then they can see over time, as back pain is increasing, these muscles tend to atrophy and they actually become a little more fatty. So, first line of defense in preventing and helping to ease low back pain is getting back in touch with this really deep but really vital muscle within the body. The tricky part is it is so deep it can be hard to connect to. It's not like one of our big superficial muscles, you might get biceps here, but not one of like our big strong muscles that you can really feel, you know, engage and contract, or you can see and engage and contract. It's subtle, but it is really important, like I said, when it comes to the health of our spine. So these studies have begun to link disc degeneration, arthritis in the facet joints, these types of issues with atrophy of the multifidi. Never mind. And so, how do we connect to it? Well, one of the best ways is to call upon another deep and kind of harder to connect with core muscle, your pelvic floor. Yes, your pelvic floor is a part of your core. So, when we can lift and engage the pelvic floor, while we're extending the spine, which is what these multifidi really assist with, right? So they're here to help you extend the spine or move into back bends without compressing the joints. So if we're just kind of moving into our back bends, kind of, like I say, like dumping into our back bends, we could be compressing these joints and not really calling upon the multifidi for support. So sometimes it takes moving a little bit slower and a little more conscious to invite that support from the pelvic floor and then to bend back with a bit more integrity and strength. Again, not kind of dumping in the joints or just moving into our flexibility if we tend to be kind of hypermobile. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to explore how to connect with this. One of my favorite ways is in Warrior One with a variation of the arms. So if you want to join me, hop on your mat. I'm going to have two blocks towards the front of my mat. We're going to balance this out with gently lengthening the multifidi after we contract them. So it's always nice to balance what we're doing with our muscles. We're going to contract, we're going to strengthen, and then we're going to fold into just a gentle spinal flexion and breathe and see if we can connect a little bit more with our multifidi. All right, so hop onto your mat, two blocks if you'd like, and we'll come into Tadasana. And before we even get started, we're going to lift all 10 toes and lift the arches of the feet. So your arches are fascially connected to your adductors, which are then fascially connected to the pelvic floor, which then is fascially connected to the deep core and the diaphragm. I know that's a lot, but all that being said, if we can lift our arches and connect with the inner thighs, that's going to help you lift and connect with your pelvic floor while we're here. Like I said, some of these deeper muscles are harder for us to connect with, so we've got to use some tricks to get there. First, we're just going to invite length, not back bending yet at all. Deep breath here. Exhale, start to bend into your front knee. Doing your best to track the knee right over the ankle. Connect back again to that back foot. See if you can lift the arch a little bit more. Deep breath in. Reach up, length through the spine. Exhale, wave forward just a little bit. Let this feel like a crunch where you're pulling the belly in and up. Maintain that sense of strength through the core and start to wave the arms back, opening into a little bit of extension. And just imagine these little muscles that run up and down the spine, contracting to support you. So exhale, wave forward. Inhale, wave back. Exhale, wave forward. Imagine this like a little crunch. Inhale, wave back. Let's do a couple more. Continuing to connect with that back arch and inner thigh lifting. And then one more time, we'll open up. Go ahead and straighten your front leg. Give it a little bit of a break. Find one more deep breath in here, lengthen. Open up, and then exhale, softly bend into your front knee, and then relax the arms down and fold over that front thigh. So you're going to bring your blocks in for support, and just let the spine round, let the head get heavy. Continue to root into your back heel, and then just breathe into your back body. Look at your back foot, spin your back heel up, so you're in more of a lunge shape. And then you're going to step your back foot up to meet your front. So we're back at the top of the mat. Just enjoy forward fold for a moment. And now start to bend into your knees. Reach your arms out in front. Connect with the strength of your back body. Let that pull you up and open you into some gentle extension. Exhale and release. So shake that out a little bit. And we'll do that on the other side. So this time we'll step the right foot back. Again, give some space between your legs here. And then take a moment to actually look back at that back foot, see what it's doing. Usually about a 45 degree angle is good, but shift, wiggle, adjust until you feel like you're able to root a bit more on the pinky toe side of your foot. And even if it's subtle, lift through the inner arch of that back foot. And see for a moment, again, you might just straighten out that front leg so it doesn't get too tired. See for a moment, if you can feel that fascial connection up through the inseam of the leg, up through the pelvic floor and the deep core, bring your arms out in front, link your thumbs. Create a little bit of traction, pulling the thumbs against one another. And then nice and slow, deep breath in. Start to wave your arms up. Just keep them reaching up at first. Exhale, bend into your front knee. Reconnect with your back foot. Reconnect with that pinky side of your back foot. Deep breath in. Exhale, wave the arms forward, pull the belly in. Inhale, wave the arms back, opening into a little bit of a back bend, but with strength and integrity. Exhale, wave forward, see if you can lift the pelvic floor. Inhale, open. Exhale. Pull the belly in. Inhale, open. One more like that. Inhale, open. Go ahead and straighten out your front leg. Cinch in around the waist. One more time, lengthen. Lift through the belly to support you as you open. Slowly bend your front knee, release the arms. Draping the spine forward, use those blocks for support. This is meant to feel good. Let the head rest down, let the spine find that nice even arc, and breathe into the back body. You're looking at that back foot, you're just going to spin your back heel up. Step your back foot up to meet your front. Move your blocks out in front of you. Bend into your knees. Arms are going to come forward, root to rise all the way up, round into your heels, and then open up just a little bit more. Beautiful. Exhale, relax your arms down. Shake out your into the feet. So start inviting these